Okay. So now what? So I get cos theta is equal to this. Now how do I convert it into a Cartesian form? Now n1,
this is my Cartesian form.
How do I convert it into the Cartesian form? My n1 can be given like this. See, n1, had it been a unit vector, it would have been given as L1 I cap plus M1 J cap plus N1 K cap. This is not a unit vector, so it will be direction ratios, okay, that you can write in small letters, that we have been writing in small letters. Now suddenly the book, your NCERT book, that writes it in capital letters, but there is no difference. Try to understand, okay. So I am following that convention of your book. So it is A I cap plus B J cap plus C K cap, correct? And N2 is, so I call it A1, B1, C1. This is A2 I cap plus B2 J cap plus C2 K cap. We get the point? C2 K cap. Now if I put it here, cos theta is equal to n1 dot n2. What is n1 dot n2? So I'll write it here. N1 dot n2 is, or leave it. So or let me write it. N1 dot n2 is A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2. Okay. Now what? So cos theta is equal to n1 dot n2 divided by mod n1 mod n2. Can you tell me what mod n1 is? What will be mod n1, Rachna? Mod. Mod is not a vector. Length of the vector, bache. Length of the vector is A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square. Root over. Why this doubt? Mod N2 is?
A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square,
root over. Okay, just plug in the values. So it becomes A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 divided by mod N1 into mod N2. A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square, root over A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square. So I have cos theta equal to A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 A1 square B1 square C1 square into A2 square B2 square C2 square. Right? So what do we have? This is your Cartesian form of the same thing. Simple. We understand that. Now an equation can be given in any of the form. So one says, find the angle between the two planes. Let me do a question. Find the, so example,
find the angle between the two planes. Between the two planes, 2x plus y minus 2z is equal to 5. 2x plus y minus 2z is equal to 5. And 3x minus 6y minus 2z. 3x minus 6y minus 2z is equal to 7. Is equal to 7 using vector method. Using vector method. Now the moment they tell you to use the vector method, you'll have to find out the n1 vector. What is the n1 vector? How can I resolve this? See, this is my, I have to convert it into this form, right? What is my xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap? This is fixed. R vector is fixed. Okay? Now I dot it with what? To get 2x, it should be 2i cap. To get 1y, it should be 1j cap. To get minus 2z, it should be minus 2k cap is equal to 5. So immediately from the Cartesian equation of a plane, we are able to extract the vector that represents the normal. Correct? So my n1 becomes this. Similarly, from the second equation, again I do the same thing. Dot 3i cap, is it not? So that this will become the product of these. Minus 6j cap, so it becomes minus 6y. Minus 2k cap, so it becomes minus 2z, is equal to 7. So from these I immediately get my n1 vector as 2i cap plus j cap minus 2k cap, and the n2 vector as 3i cap minus 6j cap minus 2k cap. Immediately you can apply the angle formula. So I have cos theta is equal to n1 n2 upon mod n1 mod n2. Now that is equal to 6 minus 6, right? 3 into 2, 6. 1 into minus 6 plus 4 divided by, what is mod of this? This is 4 root over 2 square, that is 4, plus 1 square, that is 5, plus 2 square, that is 9. So root over 9 is 3 into 9 plus 16, 25 plus 4, 29, so root 29, is it not? Is it? 9 plus 36, I am extremely sorry. 9 and 36 is 45 and 4 is 49. You said 36. Mm-hmm. I thought it's 4. Fine. I was wrong. So that is 4 upon 3 into 7. 4 upon 21. So theta is equal to cos inverse 4 upon 21. Okay? See, there are two angles, you should not lose sight of that. There is one angle is this, and the other angle between the planes is this. So if you are getting a negative value, it means somehow you are getting the obtuse. So there will have to be a corresponding acute for that. Okay, so for the acute angle, you can take a mod of it. Correct?